Thanks. Hello, everybody. So myself, Vivash Mitra. So this project we did in collaboration IIT Kharagpur and NIT Durgapur and published in 2016. So this is a work where we develop a framework to assist the commuters in public public transport. So they have public transport, so it's for social good, right? So first I'll start with the problems that commuters face. So will they avail public transport, especially in the Indian context, in Indian cities? So first of all, there is no information is available apart from big metro cities. No information is available regarding the routes that you have that you can get from the Google Transit information. Apart from that, there is no timetable available a priori at different bus stops, again, in most of the Indian cities, stops, bus stops. And over and above, inside the bus, apart from Western cities, the information board is not available where we can see the next stop or approximate time to reach the destination. So this kind of information is completely missing currently in the Indian context in public transport. Most of the public commuters, they face this kind of issues. So so if I summarize, so all this kind of problem that actually led to a very chaotic experience for the commuters who are actually commuting for availing the bus and all, and they are unaware about the next stop that they are going to reach, and they don't have any clue when they are going to reach their final destination. So in this backdrop, the objective of this project is to develop a framework where it's a low-cost framework where people can run the app on their smartphone, so that they can get two important benefits. They can locate their current information, current location, while commuting on the fly, and then also they can get the estimation, that estimated time when they can reach the destination. So the time to travel, considering traffic and different other issues that they face while commuting. So this is the objective, to provide this kind of app. The most trivial solution that we can have having a GPS. So with GPS we can monitor the location, but we know that GPS is extremely energy hungry. So if we use that in a smartphone, if we develop an app with GPS, it will be like the battery will drain very fast. So we want to avoid this GPS while developing this kind of app. So we have to minimize the usage of GPS here. So first lap. Explain the approach, the overview of the approach. So we mostly rely on the mobile sensors, the inertial sensors that we have inside the smartphone to localize its position without using GPS. So here we leverage on landmarks, which Shondi already introduced. So so landmarks can be different kinds of. It can be like Wi-Fi hotspots, or can be the GSM handoffs, or a kind of speed breaker, turns, or bus stops that we call landmarks. So they are kind of anchor points inside the route, which we characterize as a particular location. So these landmarks we're going to use for localization here. So in our approach, we have two different steps. In the first step, we'll use a data collection app to collect the set of landmarks. We'll use the inertial sensors to detect and identify the landmarks and construct a database of landmarks. And then the next step, when we let the app run, so then commuters will provide, using our app, commuters will provide the source and destination, and then where they want to travel. And then our app will collect the initial sensor data, and then it will detect landmarks. And then using our framework, it will localize, it will show the current location on the fly, and then estimate the time to reach the destination. So these are two steps. So first step is to construct, so the kind of training phase you have to construct the landmark database. So so we developed an app. We'll show the app later on. So this app actually collects the sensor data, so using the initial sensors, and it detects all the landmarks while commuting. So like, for example, bus stops or turns or speed breakers. So whenever we engage a set of volunteers, they run this app, data collection app. So when they encounter this landmark, they annotate that so that we can have this kind of ground truth while commuting. So we can have ground truth information understand about different landmarks like turns and speed breakers. And then, so we can see that using different, using different sensors, we can indeed identify different landmarks. For example, using compass, you can identify turn, or even accelerometer, we can identify the speed breakers. Also, we can identify bus stops, because when the bus approaches the stop, so this speed nearly becomes zero, and then we have some changes here in the accelerometer. So using this using these sensors, we can identify different kind of landmarks. And then once we identify those landmarks, we construct the database. We database of landmarks, and we construct a traversal graph, which is nothing but a sequence of landmarks. So assume that at a given point of time, we identify a landmark, for example, turn at location Li, and then after tau time interval, it encounters another landmark, which is a speed breaker, and its location is, for example, Lti plus 1. So this actually we get from the ground truth, so the annotators label that in that way. And in this way, we can construct this kind of traversal graph, which is a collection of landmarks. So we construct this database, so we complete this training phase. Now, when we let the system run, so then computer specifies the source and destination, as I mentioned here. Then it uses this app. So in the computer let the system run, and then it identifies a specific landmark using the sensor data. For example, B here, it identifies B as this given landmark, and then using this traversal graph that we explained, and then the landmark that it detects, it localizes its current position. So from the database, we get this information. We have this information in the database, and assume that the current point of time, we identify this a turn at a given location Li, and after time interval tau, we identify another landmark, which is a speed breaker. And following the information that we have in the database, in the traversal graph, we identify or detect the position, which is Li plus 1. So we infer that after this tau interval, with some error, we identify that the location that we have currently, this is location Li plus 1. So from this database information, we can localize this position. So as you can see, this mostly depends on the kind of the way you construct the database and you construct this traversal graph. And this is really important issue. So yeah, in this way, we can localize this position. So now there are a few issues. So we talked about landmarks. So landmarks can be different types. It can be like physical landmarks that I mentioned, like turns, speed breakers, bus stops. And we need to leverage on those landmarks because they are not very frequent. Okay, so but there are a few issues, because for turn and speed breaker it's fine, but they're because they're static in nature. But in the Indian context, bus stops are, if you look at bus stops, they're sometimes like somehow in volatile in nature, because buses may or may not occur in the route every time, because mostly in the Indian context we can find that buses sometimes skips a designated bus stop. On the other side, bus may not stop at a given bus stop there. So due to all these kind of factors, these landmarks can be volatile in nature. So so that we need to take care of. So when you construct this traversal graph that I explained in the previous slide, so we need to take care of this. So we constructed data structure is called probabilistic timed automata, so where nodes are the different landmarks, and we construct in a smart way so that we can capture this kind of volatility in nature. For example, you have a stop 1, and then you have another followed by stop 2, stop 3, and a speed breaker. Now the bus may skip stop 2, it may skip stop 3, but it later on it may encounter this speed breaker, this speed breaker here. So in that way, we construct this PTA so that we can have a link from stop 1 to stop 2, indicating that it will really stop in stop 2. There's a connection from stop 1 to stop 3, indicating that the bus may skip stop 2 and land up to stop 3. And there is a connection from stop 1 to breaker, indicating that it may skip both stop 2 and stop 3 and directly land up to this speed breaker. So in this way, we construct this PTA with some confidence, and the age weight indicates the travel time between the pair of landmarks. So in this way, we construct this traversal graph, and as I mentioned, we localize it. And so this is the kind of architecture we have. This part we this part we train our system, and then here we localize. So it's kind of navigation. Here we navigate and we construct the this landmark database. So we just explain the experimental setup quickly. So we perform this experiment in two different cities, and this is the kind of data collection app we have. People can annotate the landmarks here. We have a set of trails. We use different heterogeneous devices. And this is a kind of evaluation. So we show that we detect those landmarks pretty accurately, towns, speed breakers, and bus stops. Although due to this volatility in nature, there is some error in this bus stop detection. And so here we show the localization accuracy. So against the baseline, that is called deja vu, this standard state of the art work here. So we compared our algorithm or framework with respect to deja vu, and we observed that the localization here is pretty small with compared to the baseline algorithm overall. And here we show the travel time estimation. So we use two different baselines here. One is Google Maps. So given pair of locations, we show that against Google Map, our system performs reasonably well, and also in terms of like ground truth, real travel time. Finally, in terms of energy, since you are not going to use GPS too often, so it's significant, consumes significantly less energy here. So here, I summarize this work. So here we detect a framework. We develop a framework where we can localize in face of uncertainty, where you have this kind of volatility to the bus stops. We proposed this PTA, and we showed that the system works pretty well in terms against Google Maps and deja vu. So that's all. I'm good for a few questions.
Any questions about the panel comes on? Go ahead.
This is a state transport buses that you're talking about?
Yeah. It's our normal bus. The bus that we have in our owned by private owners in our cities like Kolkata and Durgapur. It's like public buses. It's public commuting system. Buses may not stop in a designated location. Sometimes when the passengers are not there, buses may skip the bus stop and go to the next one. So that we experienced from, I don't know, that happens actually.
Best bus in Dubai,
sorry. Yeah. Not maybe Bombay. Actually, Bombay buses are slightly better.
This is for 1 month. So it's 1 month data, and we engage 50 volunteers and two different cities and two specific routes we collected.
What's the duration of the whole project?
Oh, okay. It's like 1 year. It started in 2016, starting, and then
How do you differentiate between stopping just because of traffic or red light and a bus stop?
Right now, when we annotate, so when we collect this landmark database, there our volunteers manually annotate that, and they note that, and they have this ground truth, they have the information. Now, while having this traffic stop, this traffic stop, this signals, we have not considered that for the moment. But the point is, if you look at the kind of variance you have given signal, that may give you some indication whether that is a bus stop or that the bus stops due to the signal. Okay. So, in this work that we know that's why we have some error in detection this kind of volatile bus stops. We have this kind of problem. We face this kind of problems. Later we introspect that why we have this kind of issues, and we figure out that if we consider as an additional feature the variance of the stop, the time it stops in the bus stop, it can characterize, can discriminate between the signal and a designated bus stop.
Do you use distance travel as one of the inputs from the?
No. So we just considered as a ground. So the only the time it travels. So it's not regarding, it comes with the distance.
The distance would be more accurate in terms of telling you where you are, right?
This, so Then you have to measure. So since you localize, you can infer, you can compute the distance you travel. So there are two parts in this work. One is navigation and estimating the travel time. So in navigate, then you can figure out estimated distance that you travel. So that's kind of a derivative of this stuff.